Hi guys, Hobbs here. Doing a little roundup in Outlands. Tonight's going to be a focus on PvP. This is, I know, a PvE intro, but it's for those who haven't seen it. For those who have, you're used to my methods of rounding up the mobs in the game using my area effects, consecration, and a lot of other little tricks I explain in other videos. Tonight, though, going to focus a little bit on PvP, because when I first joined, it is a PvP server I'm on, because I wanted the additional challenge that, you know, something can happen at any time, which has been a really nice challenge and lots of fun. You never know what's going to happen, because sometimes with the mobs in the game, you can kind of predict what's going to happen, but in PvP, you never know. So now we're all geared up and ready to go in the Barrens. The reason why we went to the Barrens was a lot of these members are guild members, so we've got everybody from our highest to the lowest. Not the whole guild, but a good chunk. Actually, one of the guys had organized this and said, come on over, we're doing a run, take off all your gear, and we're going to see what kind of damage we're going to do. So I thought that was kind of a cool challenge and decided to tape it for my viewers, and we'll see what goes on, guys. So this is the first guy of the night. He's a level 70 warrior. And he's running to his zone right now. I drink a speed potion to catch up to him. I'm going to give him an old 1-2. But he zoned in. So the first one wasn't successful. As you can see, Hobbs is bald as an eagle. I know when I made this character, normally I always chose a really cool looking guy, and in my other games I've played, whether it be Warcraft or in the past Dark Ages of Camelot or even EverQuest, and over time they always looked more dorky. Like it was like they had that face. At the beginning it looked so cool, and then they just got, I don't know, something about them didn't look good. So when I made Hobbs, I chose him as ugly as I could, and he only gets better looking every day. I put an ugly set of chops on him and bald, and you know, it's funny, no complaints here. It's just you know, you try to get somebody who looks kind of cool and they end up looking an idiot, and you get somebody who looks like an idiot and he actually looks okay. What do you know? Anyways, had a few kills there. And now we're going to go test the theory. I don't know if your parents ever said, if all your friends jumped off a cliff, would you? And we're going to find out if Hobbs would or wouldn't. And there's a little horde guy. Came up to see the spectacle of a bunch of people standing there. So, back to the point. Wondering if we're going to jump or aren't we? But, I mean, depends if all our friends do. Speaking of jumping, look at this guy in the background. That horde came up, saw this, one guy approached him, and instead of fighting, he decides just to jump to his death. That's pretty cool. That was probably the funniest thing I saw all night. There we go. So a little bit of a wipe there. Nice thing is, graveyard's right there within view. So we're gonna res up. And head back on up. So much fun the first time, decided to do it again. Nice thing with dying right now is you don't have any gear to damage. So no repair bill. Speaking of gear, here's a little view of my guy. I've got all the gear and links on my blog and to the armory and that. For those of you who haven't used the official World of Warcraft armory, if you go there, click on armory, you can type in any character's name and actually see what gear they have, their mana, stats. It's great for PvP too, because if you know somebody else that maybe might be aggroing you a lot, you could always check out their gear. Find their weak spots. You'll see a horde member here. He took off his gear as well, so I don't know if he just wanted to blend in or what the case was there, but pretty interesting. So we got this level 70 warrior back when we popped up. I wasn't recording, so I had to get it just so we get the kill. That's the second kill. And one run into the... then we get the warlock again. For those of you who haven't subscribed to Wowhobbs, you'll see it on the top right-hand corner. Or if you want to see some of my other videos as well, click on More from this user. This is a little scene of me grinding. Excuse me. One thing you're going to find with grinding is at any time, a horde member could come and all of a sudden I've got all these guys on me. So you never know when you're going to have a battle. And then if you do have a battle, it's really a nice accomplishment if you do win. Which isn't always the case, but if you do, they figure you're at your weak spot. In this case, it was really nice that I actually had an alliance swing by and throw me a few heals. I do find that this happens when I'm doing the Hobbs way of pulling, because people figure you're usually in trouble. If you rode by a guy and saw that he had like 8 to 10 guys on him, you think, uh-oh, this guy's in trouble, and throw him a few heals. So, which is always nice. So you'll see the experience, getting a bunch of little kills here. For those of you who are using the Hobbs way of pulling to grind up from, let's say, level 20 and up, one thing you'll find too is sometimes if you you can do it with your same level, try to get maybe 3 to 6 guys, or you can go a couple levels higher. But if you go lower, you can get more. And you'll see here, like, I get about 700 experience a kill. Or if I do a guy my own level, I'm getting about 1,000, but there I just popped off so many more that for the same amount of time, I get a lot more. This is Taxon, who... thanks for healing me up there. He's level 61 now when I did this video, but he was level 58 when he swung by to heal me up. This is a little view of my blog. It's an older clip of the blog, but you can see this part for clicking at the bottom at older post. But all my videos, write-ups, little links to different sites on there as well. So swing by and check it out, guys. This pull is pretty neat. I'm pulled right into the cave, and there's actually a horde sitting in there, which I didn't expect. Normally, this is what I'm talking about, is they'd all be on me. I threw up my consecration, but for some reason, they all ran to him. He's a level 66 warrior, just minding his own business, sitting there, and all of a sudden, all these guys come rushing in, and he's in battle, so I think I'm just going to help the game finish him off. Hopefully get a horde kill out of this. There we go. Didn't get any experience at... that pull. For some reason they passed to him. I've never seen that before. It's always, here, as soon as I saw him in there, I'm thinking, oh, time to battle. It's great though when you have a bunch on you and you can win, but I mean, that was even better when they're all on him. It would have been neat to see through his eyes. So a lot of you have seen my, for the subscribers out there, have already seen my videos. This is revisiting the Bone Stripper Vultures. Last time I was here, I think I was level 62 or 63. 65 now. Don't have to use Lay of Hands or anything else. Good little bit of chunk of experience. Figure it's a great last pull for level 65. There we go, level 66. So, very interesting to see. I like to play the next level to the fullest. I've got new, you know, more mana, more strength, intellect, all the other stuff. I always like to see... what I can do at that level, how much abuse I can give this game, and make a couple more videos for you guys on the Hobbs way of pulling. Thanks again for watching. Means the world to me. And for those of you who haven't subscribed, subscribe and swing by my blogs. Till next time, guys.